And we're joined by Norm Letnick, the MLA for Kelowna-Lake Country. People have been talking about you over the last little while. It was suggested by a local columnist that there's a switcheroo in the works, that you might seek the mayor's job while the mayor seeks yours. Is there any possibility that this is a deal that's in the works?
Well, there's no deal. I've been asked for quite some time now if I consider running for mayor. So I've given it thought, and my answer always seems to be, if I'm needed, I will go where the people want me to go. I'm really enjoying being an MLA and working hard as a voice in Victoria, along with Renee Merrifield and Ben Stewart, and all my caucus colleagues, to hold the government to account and to deliver on commitments that I made to the people of Kelowna-Lake Country in the last election. So, just last week, I talked to the transportation minister about moving forward on medians on Highway 97 between Kelowna and Lake Country, so we won't face any more fatalities like we did a month or two ago. I talked to him about maybe getting involved provincially and getting our airport back recognized for international travel, see what he can do at the national level, if there's anything he can do. I've talked to the Minister of Education, trying to line up a meeting with the three local MLAs and the minister to talk about capital priorities for School District 23, of course, including Rutland Middle School and other schools in Glenmore and other.
Right.
So, I'm really enjoying the role that I have, that the people have given me, and I want to continue that as long as the people want me to. But when more and more people consider what's going to happen a year from now in Kelowna with a race for council, including mayor, and they asked me if I'd be interested. Well, my honest answer is yes.
That would mean setting aside your duties as an MLA, kind of quitting partway through your tenure.
Well, there's a lot of things that happened before that. Number one is I need to feel like the people want me to do that. If the people tell me, no, we'd rather you continue your role as an MLA, you have three more years in your mandate, and not run for mayor, well, then that's exactly what I'll do.
But let me ask you this. Is it fair to voters, if you put your name out and you say, yes, I'll serve as an MLA, and another opportunity comes along midway, is it fair to them to just dump that and go to the other opportunity?
Well, I don't look at it that way. I look at it as following as what the people are telling me. Right now, some of the people, and it's just some, have told me that they would like me to run for mayor. I don't know if that's the broad consensus in the community. So I'm going to go and ask the community. There's a year before the next election. And that's why I came out to the public now, so that they, when they think about, well, who could run for mayor in the next election, including the incumbent, if he chooses to do so, then, that they say, okay, well, maybe Norm's a possibility. So when I go and knock on doors, they know what I'm coming for. I'm coming for feedback from them if they want me to continue in the role as MLA, or they'd like to have my name on the ballot. Now, my name on the ballot doesn't mean I win. It just means my name's on the ballot.
Right.
And then the people, of course, will have other names to look at and choose from. And if I'm privileged with the election results that they would like to see, then somebody else will take over my role as MLA, and I would take over as the mayor. If I lose, then I would continue as the MLA. So,
do you know about any discussions, maybe not involving you directly, that might have taken place with people saying, hey, that might be a neat fit for our current mayor to slide into the MLA's role while if you were to consider running for the mayor's job?
Again, if I'm needed to run for the mayor's job, then I'll give that serious consideration. I'm open to the idea. I've done 21 years now in public service, 9 years on councils, and 12 years as an MLA. And I believe that there's still a lot of energy and passion left in me to serve my community.
Sounds like the job appeals to you.
Well, all the jobs do. I really loved being a city councilor in Kelowna. I really loved being president of a non-for-profit housing corporation. I really love being an MLA. I just love public service. And if I can do that in line with what the people want, well, that's the best of both worlds. So if the people tell me, Norm, we really want you to run for mayor, well, then I'll seriously consider that. I'm open to the idea.
Would you consider running against Colin Bazarin?
Well, if the people tell me they want me to run for mayor, then I'm sure there'll be all kinds of candidates running for mayor in the next municipal election. And it could include Colin if he wishes to run again. That's Colin's decision to make. My decision is to wait until the people tell me what they want. And being a year out gives us that flexibility where I can continue working on my primary focus, which is advocating for Kelowna and Lake Country in Victoria, and also holding the government to account with my colleagues in the legislature, but also listening carefully to what the people in the community are telling me. And you know, when you do those two things, when you continue to work hard at your job, but at the same time have an open ear to what the people are saying, then how can you go wrong? Because if the people are telling me, don't run, I won't run. It's that simple. If they're telling me, yes, we want you on the ballot, no matter who else is on the ballot, well then, you know, I have to give that serious consideration as well.
All right, thanks for your time today.
Anytime, thank you.